going, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Star Wars The Old Republic Dark Side Expansions. We are here again with Sedentaries as we have now entered a dreamlike state, and Valkorian in the previous episode was like, yeah, your companions are shit. And we were like, oh, well, I mean, they still have a usefulness before we dispose of them, you know, because we're Sith and all that good stuff. But anyways, it seems we need to make our way through this dream world of sorts. We're like in the middle of space, as you can see. Like the Eternal Fleet's out there, and battles are going on, or were going on. But we need to take on some skytroopers. Mind you, we do have to do all of this alone, apparently, because we're asleep, in a sense. Oh, got more. Go ahead and throw down one of those. Good deal. Oh, we have another one. There you are. I can see you over there, dude. Gonna make our way over here. There, I see that fourth one over there to the right now. And make sure we get them in there. There we go. Seems that we are having issues with our health a bit. Stronger than the other two. Defeat visions of my past. So Thanaton and Zash. Interesting. Deuces. Let me go up this way. There's Valkorian. And I see a dead Ashara. You barely tapped your true potential.
It is time you are unleashed. Do not presume to know me. My power is beyond your imagination.
Superior to the murderous fools in charge here.
This empire failed because of you. Someone like me could lead it to victory.
Do not waste time following the path of Mar and Malgus. There is no redemption here. The Dark Council, Imperial Intelligence, Mandalorians, all fail. You alone find victory.
I'm trapped in carbonite, dying of poison, and talking to you. This doesn't feel like winning.
A worm enters a chrysalis to grow wings. It never crawls again and never looks back. This empire is not worth saving, and the Republic is not worth destroying. There is a greater purpose awaiting us.
You want to take back your turn of fame.
They want someone to blame for their defeat. They choose you.
I won't waste my strength fighting things that aren't real.
These are not illusions. Empire, Republic, both fall before the Eternal Throne. You cannot stop what is to come. Save yourself.
Revive fallen citizens. One. Any behind me? No. Okay. Number two. Not the way. This is the way. We gotta go down. 3, 4. See a fifth one over here. 5. Six, seven, eight, and nine over here. Number 10 over there. Gotcha. Ooh. Got some Sith. Another one over here. Goodbye. Sith Lord. We take spacecraft in our dreams. Thank you very much. Ooh, Darth Maul. Heard your weakness was lightning.
Thank you.
out of here.
Did it please you to kill him yourself? I sensed you felt cheated when I disposed of him.
This dream is a big joke to you, isn't it?
I seek only to open your eyes.
Alright, we just got killed in our own dream and respawn at a different area. Lesser monolith. Whoa there, big fella. Mr. Valkorian over here, how are you doing?
Zios, the world where everything changed. For me, you, the galaxy.
You killed every living being here.
They died. Opening my eyes to the truth. I have passed beyond death week.
Both Jedi and Sith have sought immortality. What makes you the exception?
I am not hindered by the teachings of failures. Our flesh is not who we are. Voices, hands, children. I no longer require those crude vessels.
Will you be free when the carbonite poison and kills you?
Perhaps. But then it is not my goal. I have done all I can to preserve your life.
Why would you do that?
You are a part of me I wish to keep.
Well, that's bigger than the last big boy.
I cannot save you unless you want to live.
We're very prideful as a Sith.
Sith, do not beg for rescue. Through passion, I gain strength.
Show me.
All right, big boy. Let's tussle. He's a fire in his laser. Out of that. He's a pretty simple boss to take on. You just gotta stay out of the way of his freaking flaming breath. The occasional yippee-ki-yay. Come on, big boy. Make sure you got some good heals going on, just in case. Especially if you don't accept Valkorian's help. Down he goes. Go ahead and grab the credits if you want them, and then go talk to Valkorian.
You are the only one who has ever matched my will to survive.
Stop comparing yourself to me.
You cannot deny we share a common foe.
Representatives from both the Republic and the Empire.
The Eternal Throne, the new seat of power in the galaxy.
It can't be. I've only been gone
longer than you think. Zakul has surpassed my expectations. The most powerful fleet in history, and an army of guardians who know the Force is more than light or dark. But my children abuse their power.
What did you expect? You're their role model.
Different here. Abandoning my past let me experience pleasures and denied myself before. And who love on Zakul? Who knows? Even you may find it.
The only thing you love is power.
I care about more than you know. We must deal with my errant son and daughter before they ruin everything.
I knew you wanted something. You can't stop me now.
They are deadly, and they lack discipline. Do not underestimate their threat. It will take both of us to undo the damage they can inflict.
Your daughter sees me.
Very well, my dear.
there's a familiar voice. Chapter 3, Outlander.
Don't try to move. You're dying. I may have your cure, but I'm not going to lie. This will hurt. That wasn't quite so bad.
You changed your hair, Lana.
Lana, you saved my life.
I spared you from dying this very instant. We still have quite a ways to go. Gear up, quickly.
Is that a Republic model?
T-701. He's agreed to help rescue you.
Not a very big crew.
Yes, well, it's the best I could manage.
T-7 is from the Jedi Knight story.
The Empire and Republic have all but fallen to the man who imprisoned you. You're our last hope. Come on.
Alrighty. We have been rescued by Miss Lana Beniko now. And from here, I'm pretty sure you can customize her however you want. She does become like a permanent companion of yours. I'll probably customize her off screen. But we'll probably wait till further on into the expansion before we optimize outfits and stuff. That way it kind of goes in with the story, because we wouldn't just change like right here. We would change once we get to a better location. Let's go ahead and do that. Someone came online. Who came online? Okay. Let's see. People running everywhere.
What kind of prison is this?
It's no prison. It's possessions.
Yes.
Don't you feel special now?
Go over this way. Get back, fool. Cut those feet.
I've got the door.
Do you? Open sesame. Open sesame, you. Okay. Nope, never mind.
That droid generating false security alerts in other sectors. Capable little astromech. Yes, I read you.
An updated timetable would be good.
Why, is there a problem?
No problem. But we are starting to feel a bit exposed out here. You find the Outlander yet?
Yes, I've patched her in.
Great. I'm Koth Ortena. Welcome to the most suicidal rescue mission in history. Hope you're everything Lana said you were.
Be patient, Koth. We're on our way.
Koth will fly us out of here. Just as soon as we're through this door. I've seen her before.
No.
High Justice Bailey, the intruders have released the Outlander. Skytroopers are scouring the building,
but go on, don't be shy.
But There are alarms sounding in multiple sectors. We can't seem to pin them down.
Well, don't you worry. Everybody makes mistakes. We're not ready. Not for Vayner. We don't have a time limit.
Oh, so now you can use both hands.
Let's get you out of here. Hurry. Skytroopers, Valen's far from alone.
She just breaks it apart. Lana struggled just to open it, and she just like says, "Honey, I'm home." Actually just going to end the episode off here, guys. In the next episode, we will continue on with Chapter 3. And, yeah, we'll see where everything happens, and let's go from there. So, until then, guys, take care. Hope you enjoyed. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I'll see you on the next episode.